Well, I'm Peter Higgs, a retired, long retired professor of theoretical physics at Edinburgh University. Well, I think if I had not become a scientist, the kind of thing which interested me most was music. But I didn't really notice that I had any talent there, so I didn't pursue that one. I'm happy to say that some of my family are doing rather better in that way, particularly my granddaughter. Well, I think it was a gradual process. My high school education was in Bristol at Cotton School. One of the influences on me there clearly was the presence of a name on the school honours board of Paul Dirac, one of the founders of quantum mechanics, and I was certainly curious about what he'd done, and my interest in physics was largely what I read outside the curriculum. The curriculum I found rather boring, and I never did well in physics in school. I never got a prize for my physics. So by the time I finished high school, I'd come to the conclusion that I wasn't, after all, going to follow in my father's footsteps and become an engineer, because I had no signs of practical skills. And what's more, it was becoming evident that I had not enough practical skills to be an experimental physicist. So what was left for me? I had to be a theoretical physicist, and I was interested in elementary particles. So that's where I ended up. Well, I certainly enjoyed teaching the students very, very, very much. Once I'd mastered my fear of standing up and giving lectures, which took a bit of time, I enjoyed very much combining teaching and research. In the late 50s, I spent several years in London as an ICI fellow, purely in research, and I resigned it early and took a temporary lectureship at University College London, because I felt I wasn't getting enough satisfaction from what I was doing entirely in research. I wasn't productive enough, and I liked the stimulus of doing teaching as well. Well, my advice would be take courses, university or otherwise, which had a broad enough base for you to be able to change direction when you feel the need to. That's probably the most important thing, because the whole business is becoming more and more cross-disciplinary. People who start off in physics go and do molecular biology, or they start off in physics and they move into informatics and so on. And there's a lot of movement possible, provided you've got the right sort of basis to do it.